Hi, I'm Martina and today I'm looking inside an electronics factory where surface mount components are soldered onto printed circuit boards. On this product the components are down to 0402 size, 1mm long, and need to be precisely placed and soldered. This all happens on an automated pick and place assembly line. Here are two next to each other. These are pretty typical and almost all of them work in the same way. Hopefully this video will fill in some of the details that others tend to skip over, and it was too windy to fly a drone. Let's begin. These PCBs are in panels of four circuits, here stacked in a loader that feeds into the stencil printer. The printer uses a large stainless steel laser cut stencil, exactly matching where the full panel requires solder paste. Both have these alignment marks called fiducials. A camera in the printer uses a prism to look both up and down, checks the fiducials and adjusts the precise position of the stencil. Solder paste is tiny balls of solder suspended in flux. The flux dries out, so there's a use-by date. The printer uses blades to press the paste through the stencil and onto the panel. You should get a nice clean print, with the right thickness of paste almost exactly aligned with where it needs to be. With components this small, any error in the print causes problems later on. This one looks okay. After inspection, the panel goes into the pick and place machine. Every individual circuit on the panel has its own fiducials. The machine checks every one to correct for any variation of the exact position of each circuit. Then, robotic suction nozzles begin placing components onto the paste. This machine has two heads with eight nozzles each. The components usually arrive on reels of tape. The tapes are loaded onto feeders, and the feeders onto the machine. They're designed to peel off the thin cover layer from the tape and present one component at a time when the machine calls for it. The precise position of the tape needs to be corrected in the program by the operator. Usually pick and place machines can hold between 50 and 100 feeders. Different sized components call for different nozzles. The machines exchange them automatically. Tapes and feeders come in different sizes and types too, but most are these 8mm punched paper. After picking up each component, cameras, here using red light, check each component and its exact angle. The nozzles rotate to correct for this before placing them. Usually a pick and place line will have a number of similar machines, with the components shared across them. The programs are carefully optimized to share the work efficiently and to decide where the feeders are loaded onto each machine. Normally, the first machine is set to take slightly longer than the others. This prevents a traffic jam of PCBs on the line, which is normally fine unless something goes wrong. In real life, things often go wrong. This shot went wrong, but it still looks cool. So now you have some assembled PCBs, but the components are just resting on the paste in a fragile state. Great care needs to be taken to not mess them up. This is also an opportunity to inspect them and correct any errors. Here some connectors are being poked to make sure they're sat down properly in the paste. Any recurring errors are corrected in the program. Every machine has a stack light to show its status. Green lights are good. New reels of components are spliced to the old ones like this while the machine's still running. Hopefully before the old one runs out. If a component does run out, the machine will show an amber light and stop until the operator replenishes it. After inspection, the PCBs go into a reflow oven. This bakes them at up to around 270 Celsius to a carefully controlled time and temperature profile. This reflow oven uses convection. Multiple temperature zones, top and bottom, are maintained by these heated air chambers with fans within, gently blowing onto the PCBs, which travel slowly along this steel conveyor belt holding their edges. It's important to heat the PCBs at the right rate. This melts and activates the flux, removing oxidation from the components and their pads before the solder balls melt in the hottest zone. Then the PCBs are cooled a little to solidify the solder before emerging. If all has gone well and the profile was correct, you now have some nicely soldered panels of PCBs. Let's look at one more closely. It's worthwhile to inspect them again to look for problems like tombstones, where a component is stood up at one end. This one looks pretty good. What happens to the PCBs after leaving the oven varies. Here they pass to a magazine unloader. This unloads PCBs from the line and puts them in racks. Many factories stack them by hand. Here it's automatic. For this production run, the full magazines will be flipped over and wheeled back to the start of the second line. Then this process will all happen again to put more components on the other side. Yeah, this video will probably die, so if you did watch this far and didn't hate it, please do click the things to show YouTube and me that that was the case. Thank you for looking at things with me.